In today's Motion Magic, we'll build this Final Cut Pro 10 transition with Motion. After launching Motion, I'll select a Final Cut transition project, use the 1080 preset at 29.97 frames per second. I'll set a duration of 2 seconds, and I'll click Open. Then I'll press Shift-Z to fit the canvas to the window. By default, a transition project switches from the outgoing clip to the incoming clip in the middle with a straight cut. We'll obscure that cut with some animating shapes. I'll make sure the playhead is at the start of the project, then from the toolbar I'll select the rectangle tool. And I'll hold down the Shift key and drag in the canvas to make a square shape. Then I'll use the distort tool to skew the shape. And I'll press Shift S to switch back to the default transform tool. To make copies of the shape, I'll use a replicator, but in order to keep the skew distortion, I first need to put this shape in its own group. With this group selected, I'll click the Replicator button in the toolbar. I'll move the new group containing the replicator to the top of the layers list. Right-click in the canvas to switch to the Replicator tool and spread it out to cover the canvas. I need more rows and columns. In the Replicator Inspector, I'll increase their number and adjust the size so they completely cover the underlying placeholders. To animate these shapes onto and off the screen, I'll go to the library, to Behaviors, to the Replicator Behavior, and I'll drag the Sequence Replicator Behavior onto the Replicator. In the Behavior Inspector, I'll add the Opacity parameter and set it to 0%. Then I'll change the sequencing to through inverted and set the spread to about 10. If I play the project now, the shapes animate on from the center out, but I want them to move across the screen. So I'll return to the Replicator Inspector and change the origin to left. Now the shapes animate on from left to right, and the underlying clips switch when they're mostly covered by the shapes. To add outlines of these shapes moving in the opposite direction, I'll first duplicate the group containing the rectangle, select the copy of the rectangle, and in the heads-up display, I'll uncheck the fill and check the outline. In the layers list, I'll option-click the checkbox for the shape in order to solo it so I can see what it looks like and adjust as needed. Then I'll option-click again to unsolo. Now, I'll duplicate the group containing the replicator and drag my new rectangle group onto the cell of this new replicator to make the outlined rectangle the new source object of this copy. I'll select this new replicator, and in the Replicator Inspector, I'll change its origin to right. Before I play the project, I'll take a moment to organize my work by renaming my groups. Now when we play, we get two animations moving through each other. To allow for variations in Final Cut Pro 10, I'll publish several parameters of these replicators, like origin, shuffle order, and angle end. I publish them by right-clicking on the parameter I want to publish. For the replicator behaviors, I'll publish the spread and the traversal. I'll select the project in the layers list, then in the project inspector under publishing, I'll rename and reorder my published parameters. In the properties inspector, I'll click the override FCP checkbox to force this transition to remain 2 seconds long by default. Finally, I'll publish this project by pressing Command S and give it a category and a name. Now in Final Cut Pro 10, in the transitions browser, I can select that new category, preview my transition, and apply it to an edit point in my project. And in the transition inspector, I can use my published parameters to modify it. Click the subscribe button below. If you have an idea, comment, or suggestion, leave those below as well. Go to rippletraining.com for fast professional training on Final Cut Pro, Motion, and DaVinci Resolve from industry professionals.